Note: the following video depicts a specific configuration of the notebook. The same removal and replacement procedures apply to all configurations of the notebook. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure, battery, solid-state drive, wireless module, wireless WAN module, hard disk drive assembly, middle frame, keyboard, CPU fan, and VGA fan. Removal. Remove the two 3mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the display panel cable bracket to the system board and remove the display panel cable bracket. Disconnect the display panel cable from its connector on the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the LED board ZIF connector and disconnect the LED board ribbing cable from the system board. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ripping cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the touchpad board ZIF connector and disconnect the touchpad board ribbing cable from the system board. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbing cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the smart card reader ZIF connector and disconnect the smart card reader ribbing cable from the system board. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbing cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the fingerprint reader board ZIF connector and disconnect the fingerprint reader board ribbing cable from the system board. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbing cable. Disconnect the speaker cable from its connector on the system board. Remove the three 5mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the metal support bracket to the system board and remove the metal support bracket. Remove the five 5mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the system board to the top cover. Lift the system board off of the alignment pins on the top cover and remove. Caution! Do not lift the system board by the heatsink. To avoid any damage to the system board, handle it as close to its center as possible. Replacement. Note: before installing a new system board, remove the following from the old system board and install onto the new system board. Memory boards, heatsink, graphics board, real-time clock battery. Place the system board onto the alignment pins on the top cover. Caution! To avoid damage, ensure that all cables are free from being pinched between the system board and top cover. Replace the five 5mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the system board to the top cover. Place the metal bracket into position and replace the three 5mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure it to the system board. Connect the speaker cable into its connector on the system board. Insert the fingerprint reader board ribbing cable into the fingerprint reader board ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbing cable. Insert the smart card reader ribbing cable into the smart card reader ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbing cable. Insert the touchpad board ribbing cable into the touchpad board ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Insert the LED board ribbon cable into the LED board ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Connect the display panel cable into its connector on the system board. Place the display panel cable bracket into position and replace the two 3mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure it to the system board. Important: after system board replacement, be sure to complete post-installation tasks as required that may include verifying functionality of the notebook, updating the BIOS, updating DMI and other settings.